Hi, let's talk about the nasal septum. The nasal septum is the physical structure which divides left from right nasal cavity, and it consists of three parts. There's the ethmoid, the vomer, and the septal cartilage. In an osteological specimen, we're only going to be able to see the ethmoid and vomer. The septal cartilage will not be present. But let's focus on what we can see. So, first of all, the ethmoid bone is quite secretive. Ethmoid comes from the Greek ethmos, which means a sieve. And so it's very cancellous. It's very much full of foramina. In the anterior view of the skull here, we can see probably the least cancellous part of the bone, which is this perpendicular plate of the ethmoid. We can also see the middle conchae, which are of the ethmoid bone. We cannot see the superior conchae, which are also of the ethmoid bone. So this perpendicular plate of the ethmoid bone comes down, and it is going to meet on an anteroposterior oblique axis, the vomer. So the vomer rises up from the maxilla here to meet the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid. So on the inferior view of the skull here, we can see here are the maxillae, and here are the palatine bones, which have fused together along the midline. I'll outline here. So these two are forming the hard palate, keeping in mind that the soft palate continues beyond the hard palate. So we have the choani, the nostrils, the internal nostrils there. And separating the two of these are the, or is the vomer. And we could outline the vomer here. Vomer comes from Latin for plowshare, which is the shape of the vomer. And these lateral processes, or parts to the vomer, are the ala, or the wings of the vomer, and they're best viewed from an inferior position. Now, looking in profile, we get a better sense for how these elements come together. So let's outline the vomer here. So here it is up against the sphenoid. This is the sphenoidal sinus. Here is the hard palate coming back and arising out of the floor of the maxilla, and the palatine bones is the vomer. And we can see how this is in fact shaped like a plowshare. Superior to the vomer is the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid, descending down from the roof of the nasal cavity. And anterior to the ethmoid and anterior superior to the vomer is the septal cartilage. That septal cartilage is going to be in the anterior portion of the nasal cavity, and it is going to be the only bony portion within the vestibule of the nose. So this isn't a perfect, at least sagittally sectioned individual, because we don't have the completeness of the nares here. But we can see, at least on this part, this would be the columella, the nasal columella, and that is going to be just inferior from the septal cartilage of the nose. So tripartite partition. Septal cartilage is anterior, and as we move posteriorly, we have the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid and the vomer. These are both going to be invested by mucosa, or I should say all three of these elements will be invested by mucosa. These elements will have their own neurovasculature, and that is something that we will see in another video. Thank you very much for your time.